History was made this morning, 460 miles above the Earth's surface. Two crew members on the Polaris Dawn successfully completed the first ever commercial spacewalk. It's a collaboration between Elon Musk's SpaceX and billionaire Jared Isaacman, who uttered these words into space.
SpaceX, back at home, we all have a lot of work to do, but from here, Earth sure looks like a perfect world.
The big goal of the risky feat, testing out spacesuits and technology that researchers hope will one day help humans walk on Mars. NBC's Tom Costello is reporting on this with us. Also with us, Mike Massimino, a former NASA astronaut and Columbia University professor. Okay, Tom, this was a dangerous mission. How did they make it work?
Well, it was risky because for the first time, what they're doing is they're opening up the, or they opened up the entire spacecraft to the vacuum of space. That's the way they did spacewalks back in the 1960s, for example, the very first Soviet and American spacewalks. But they opened up the entire spacecraft to the vacuum of space, bled out the oxygen, and these two astronauts, first Jared Isaacman and then SpaceX engineer Sarah Gillis, stepped out. I got to say, it was more of a stretching exercise than it was walking because they were really trying to gauge how flexible are their new spacesuits? How much arm maneuverability and leg maneuverability do they have? Because to your point, they want to eventually use this brand new spacesuit for missions to the moon and also to Mars. So they don't have an airlock on this particular spaceship. And so that's why they had to open up the entire ship. Everybody, all four astronauts, had to don their spacesuits. Only two actually went out. And then they were concerned a little bit about their precise location. They're three times higher than the space station because during that entire walk and during the mission to get there, you know, Elon Musk even said we're worried about 10,000 satellites and bits of space debris out there and radiation from the Van Allen radiation belts that orbit the Earth. So there have been a lot of variables here that they really needed to make sure that they navigated perfectly. And boy, did they. Now, you may be watching at home thinking, okay, I've seen spacewalks before. Why does this matter? It matters because this is a private company that is doing this, SpaceX, that has really, I think, by all, you know, everyone's account, has now surpassed NASA in many ways, and certainly Boeing, in pushing forward new avenues and new ways to get into space and to really kind of push the envelope, if you will. So now you've had four private citizens, four commercial astronauts, and they have now not only gone into space, but two of them on a spacewalk testing out this new technology. I think this is yet again turning another chapter in space exploration going forward.
This is so cool. The level of jealousy at this table, I'm guessing, is off the charts. Yeah. And that includes
Tom's
me.
A little jealous too, though.
Yeah, Tom, yeah. Forget it. He would go out there in a heartbeat. But how important is this? What kind of new horizons could this open? I think there was somebody in the Science Journal who said this is the most exciting time in space flight since the 60s.
Well, I think there's a lot to be excited about. This is just one thing. But as far as the commercial component of space travel, this is something NASA has wanted for decades, and now it's coming through fruition. As Tom said, this is kind of like the spacewalks they did back in the 1960s. It was kind of interesting for me. I was thinking about this, that the first flights we had a few years ago, the suborbital flights, the private flights that they had, were kind of like the very first flights that Americans took back in the early 60s. And then we've had orbital flights with private citizens, and now we have the first spacewalk. So I think, you know, the next thing that's coming up, as Tom said, might be looking at opportunities to go even further with people privately, building space stations, private space stations, and then on to the moon and Mars. The checkout of that spacesuit, though, goes beyond the commercial programs. I think it's something that NASA would be very interested in as well. They're developing spacesuits, planetary suits that they could use on the moon and Mars. The spacesuit I used in space, they've been using that same, they still use the same spacesuit, more or less the same spacesuit since, and there I am using it there.
Look at you. Yeah,
that's my helmet. And there we are at the Hubble. But they've been using that one since the early 1980s. And so this, they're looking at new generation spacesuits, and this was a great first check of it.
I literally got chills watching you do that. When I've spoken to astronauts before, I will never forget what they told me about what it's like the first time you're in space looking down at Earth.
Yeah.
what it feels like, how it changes you. What was that like for you?
Especially from the spacewalk, because when you're looking through the window of the spacecraft, it's pretty cool. But when you get to go outside, like Jared and Sarah got to do today, even just for a couple minutes like they did, you get a chance to see the Earth, and that with the curve of the Earth at the altitude they were in, and the whole sky opens up, the universe opens up. But what's most compelling is the Earth. I felt like when I just lost my thoughts, it just concentrated on the view I had. I felt I was looking into heaven. As I couldn't imagine any place being more beautiful than our planet. And you look in the other direction, and it's kind of cool out there, you know, stars and stuff. But we've checked out the neighborhood. We got nowhere to go. So you see the beauty, and you see the fragility of it. And the other thing that struck me was everybody's down in the same place. And when I think of home now, I think of Earth, and it's a place we all share. So those are the things I took with me from my spacewalks, in addition to a lot of work. You know, the taxpayers' dollars was put to work as we were fixing the telescope and doing the technical job. But the emotional part of it is amazing.
One of the arguments that was always made when there were challenges about the budget and should we be spending so much money on NASA is, well, we're doing all these things that will have real-world implications for making our Earth a better place, whether it's curing a disease or new technology. Mm-hmm. Is that still true? Is there still an incredible place for new development in space?
Yeah, absolutely. I think the International Space Station, I think, is a great example of that. It's been up there for over two decades. People have been on board continuously, changing people out for over 20 years. The discoveries they make, the research they do in basic research, whether it's in physics, in astrophysics, looking up, looking down at our planet, trying to understand that, effects on the human body. I think that's been a great benefit. I think international cooperation between NASA and its other partners around the world. And I think we're now seeing one of the big benefits that NASA has been working toward for decades, which is the stimulation of a commercial space business so it can help our economy. And so that's why I think this is so important. It's important not just for the private astronauts and SpaceX, but I think also for the whole country and for NASA as well.
Professor Mike Massimino,
yes.
Your students are lucky to have you. Wow, that's so cool.
Thank you.
Should we do it?
We have a tweet from space.
We do?
We have a tweet from the crew, yeah. Or a post on X, as they say these days. That's right, the crew tweeted, what else would they do? Hello, Earth, we're so grateful for all the support. Please enjoy two recent photos from a mission and stay tuned for the next message. And this is what's interesting, Mike. They sent it via the Starlink, which, of course, is Elon Musk's satellites. The laser light technology, which is yet another new piece of communication technology they're testing out right now.